broadcast tonight, Philippine Vice President Sara Duterte brands critics of her confidential funds as enemies of the state. The House Speaker denies politics was behind a congressional move to strip Duterte of her confidential funds. RG Cruz has tonight's top story.
House Speaker Martin Romualde stands pat on the decision of the House leadership to realign the confidential funds of Vice President Sara Duterte in her executive office and the Department of Education. The House Chief, however, maintains that they remain open to the Vice President's inputs on how to best serve the requirements of her offices.
Right now, no, decision of the House, no, and we had a caucus, so to speak, or we had a conference with the party leaders that, for the time being, the CIF will be, realigned and put to other departments or agencies that will be best suited to conduct security aspects, no, of the secretary or the VP's concern. We are always open and welcoming the OVP and the secretary to give us suggestions, recommendations on whatever requirements, no, for whatever needs that the department or her office needs.
The speaker also urged observers not to read too much into the move since it comes after months of tension between him and the vice president when Duterte left the speaker's political party.
Borrowing the words of the vice president that even she says that she could live without it, and she would leave it to the sound discretion of the Congress for its proper disposition. Under the circumstances, we felt that it would best be realigned to the agencies and to the departments and into the areas where we have just mentioned that are a priority.
The speaker doesn't even see any conflict between their move and the vice president's statement calling critics of the confidential funds enemies of the public. On Wednesday, the vice president told the public to be wary of critics of the funds, who she accused of harboring insidious motivations.
Anyone who attacks or undermines funds allocated for peace and order is naturally assumed to have insidious motivations. Such actions go against the protection and well-being of the citizenry. Kung sino man ang kumukontra sa confidential funds ay kumukontra sa kapayapaan. Kung sino ang kumukontra sa kapayapaan ay kalaban ng bayan.
The country's second highest official also explained to policemen in Butuan the role of confidential funds in ensuring peace and order.
Confidential funds play a vital role in maintaining security by providing the necessary resources to address unforeseen challenges swiftly and decisively. Whether it is combating terrorism, tackling organized crime, or safeguarding the integrity of our nation, these funds enable our law enforcement agencies and intelligence bodies to protect our citizens effectively.
Duterte explained that the utilization of the funds should be gauged not by the number of days they were spent, but how it safeguarded the public.
The allocation of confidential funds should not be constrained by time. It matters not whether it takes one day or one year of spending. What truly matters is the safety and security of our people.
But Albay Representative Edsel Lagman fired back at Duterte, telling her that security is not her mandate. Romualdez, for his part, says that they are actually following up on the VP's position, so they are realigning surveillance money to the West Philippine Sea.
We are one with the Vice President in having to make sure that the confidential and intelligence funds, you know, are always part of the equation, and of course, best left with the agencies and departments, no, that are most and best suited. That's why, because of the recent incidents, we are also making sure that CIF is properly deployed for the West Philippine issues.
The small committee, the House tasked to finalize changes to the proposed 2024 budget, is expected to wrap up work by October 10. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.